Hi, in this video I'll show you exactly how you can publish your article at Storyline 360 course to SCORM and Thinken API, which settings you need, and how you can test your published course. Hi, I'm Mark Spearman from Upward Online Learning, where I teach you how you can create your own e-learning modules with article at Storyline. And are you new here? Then don't forget to hit the subscribe button and click the bell notification icon so you won't miss any of my upcoming videos. Are you ready? Then let's get started.
If your Storyline course is finished, the next step is to publish your course. If you want to publish in Articulate Storyline, you can do this if you go to your Home tab and you can find the Publish option here. And on all other tabs, for instance, the animations or design, you can find the preview option. And beneath there you see the publish option. So let's click on publish. Now you see here 7 different publication options, but we want our course to be published to an LMS, so we choose LMS. Sounds logical, right? Before we look to all the properties, let's look at the different outputs options for LMS. There are here SCORM 1.2, SCORM 2004, AICC, and the Thinken API. Now, which outputs option you choose depends entirely on what your LMS supports. And the most output options are SCORM 1.2 and the Thinken API. Now, what I do now is I select SCORM 1.2 and click on reporting and tracking. Now you see here some LMS course information, for instance, a title, a description, and an identifier. Now the title and the description will show in the LMS. This, what you can do best is to give this prescriptive title and a proper description for your e-learning course. The identifier is an ID, so each course has to have an unique identifier so it can be searched on in your LMS. Also, you can here give on which version of your module it is. For instance, if you publish it the first time to the LMS, it's version 1. You can fill in how long it takes the user to do your module. You can fill in what some keywords. And here you have LMS lesson SCORM information. So this is for your course, but SCORM has different scopes. And this is for the SCORM input, but most LMSs support the LMS course information. And what you also have to set is the LMS reporting, which report status you send to the LMS. And here you can choose from a past incomplete, past filled, complete incomplete, and complete filled. If you want to know which report status you have to choose, check your LMS supplier with a reporting status they want so that your module is completed in the LMS when a user has finished your module. Now let's look at tracking. Here you have several tracking options to see if your module is completed. So you can in Articulate Storyline track using a number of slides. So that means for all slides in your e-learning module. So I have 8 slides in my module. So if a user has seen all 8 slides, Articulate Storyline sends a completion status to the LMS. You can also use a quiz result slide. So if a user has passed your quiz, then a completion status or a passed status is sent to your LMS. And what you also can do in Articulate Storyline is set a specific trigger to complete your course. And I will show you how you can do it. So for instance, if you go to the last page of your course, you could set a trigger that sends complete course, for instance, complete passed, when the timeline of your last slides ends. And if we now go back to publish and go back to tracking, you see that I can also choose for the track using complete course trigger. Now, if Storyline execute this trigger, Storyline automatically sends the completion status to your LMS and a user can see in the LMS that he has completed or passed the module. So if I change my output option for LMS from SCORM 1.2 to Thinken API and I click reporting and tracking, you'll see that there are less fields to fill in. You have a title, a description, also an identifier, and you have to give in a launch URL. This is your story HTML file. And also here you can set your tracking. Also here, give a descriptive title and a proper description. So this is for the reporting and tracking options for SCORM 1.2 and Thinkin API. And let's see what you can also set for the properties to publish your course. Here at the properties, you can choose the output format, for instance, HTML5 only. I'm using the modern player in Storyline, so I only have the option to publish to HTML5 only. Or you're using the classic player in Storyline, you can also publish to Flash or publish to HTML and use Flash as a fallback. Now here you can see that I use the modern player and I can change here my player to the classic player if I want. Here you can set your quality. Standard Storyline sets the quality to the video quality to 5, audio bitrate to 56 kilobytes per second, and the image quality to 80%. But I don't want the Storyline does the compression for me. So therefore I set it to custom and set all the sliders to the right. And I click on OK. And also you can choose what you want to publish. For instance, your entire project, but you can also publish a single scene or a single slide. For instance, if you want to test something, you can publish a single scene or you can publish a single slide in Articulate Storyline. Now, if all the properties are set, your LMS output options are set, and you have give your module a proper title and a description, then you can click on the publish button. And now Articulate Storyline will publish your module. If your module is published, you have to zip your Articulate Storyline package, because you always have to have a zip file that you must upload to your LMS. So let's zip our content right now. And you can give a zip file a name and click on save. And now Storyline will create a zip file for you. And you'll see Storyline has created the zip file for me. So open a browser and in your address bar, fill in cloud.scorm.com. And you will see this page. Now, if you don't have an account yet, then you can here click on sign up now. Now here you can fill in your account information, and cloud.scorm has different plans, and we will choose now the free plan. And it is only one limitation, that you can only upload zip files that are less than 100 MB large. Let's fill in the information and then you can click on submit. Now I already have an account, so I will log in now and show you how you can use cloud.scorm when you're logged in. So I'm logged in now in cloud.scorm, and you see here a menu with home, your library. Here are all your courses. Now I have no courses right now. Your recent activity and recent active users. So if you want to upload your SCORM file, click on add content and choose for import a SCORM AICC XIP file. And now you can pick the file that we've just created. So that was this file, and I click on open. And now we click on import course. And now cloud.scorm will upload the course for us. So cloud.scorm has uploaded the course for us. And now you can launch your course and test it. And then you can see here in this dashboard if the completed status is set, what the score is, how many seconds or how long a user has taken the course. So if I launch my course, cloud.scorm.com opens a pop-up window. And now if I'll click through my course, go to the last slide and wait till my timeline ends, and I'll close my course, click on back to LMS. Cloud.scorm lets me see that my course is complete, so I know my completion status trigger works. Now there was no score, so the score is unknown, and I've done 70 seconds over this course. So, and this way you can check your course before you're going to upload it in your LMS. So now you know how to publish your course to SCORM or Thinkin API, and you know how to create an account on cloud.scorm.com, and how you can test your e-learning module, so know that your completion status works and if your score is communicated in the right way to your LMS.
Do you have any questions about publishing to SCORM or the Thinkin API? Or have you any questions about Articulate Storyline 360 in common? Then put your comments below this video and I'll promise to answer it. If this video was useful to you, then hit the like button below. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button and click the bell notification icon so you won't miss any of my upcoming videos that I publish every Thursday on YouTube. Thanks for watching and have a great day!